Why do so many good people, even Christians, support leaders who promote laws and values that go against God's word and yet despise a man like Trump? What if I told you this isn't just a political disagreement, but the result of spiritual deception? Right now, there's an invisible war being fought for the future of America, and the enemy's goal is to keep people blinded. Just as the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 4:4, the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers. In this video, we are uncovering the real difference between Trump and Kamala Harris and why Trump has been chosen by God to promote righteousness and why Harris is part of an agenda to enslave the nation spiritually. Stay with me because the battle we face is not political, it is spiritual. And the only way to win is through prayer. The real difference between these two leaders lies far beyond policies and platforms. This is about the future of America and the spiritual forces shaping it. Why do so many seemingly good people misunderstand Donald Trump? Why are they seeing him as the enemy when in reality he has been chosen by God for a crucial mission? I know this may sound controversial, but what if I told you the real reason behind this is deeper than politics? There's a spiritual battle happening right now, one that's manipulating minds, altering perceptions, and keeping people in the dark. Let's talk about what's really going on. There are demonic forces, frequencies in the spiritual realm, altering the way people perceive truth and reality. These forces are blinding people, making them see good as evil and evil as good. This deception is why many can't recognize that Trump is being used by God for a higher purpose, while Kamala and others are advancing agendas that are in direct opposition to God's word. The Bible wants us that our fight is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, and rulers of darkness. What we are seeing in the world today, especially with how people react to Trump, is a result of demonic frequencies. Yes, literal frequencies in the spiritual realm. Trump, despite his flaws, is on assignment from God to restore righteousness in this nation. He stands for policies that defend life, freedom of worship, and biblical principles. On the other hand, Kamala Harris represents a different kind of leadership, one aligned with agendas that undermine the Word of God. She supports laws and practices that distort God's design for life, family, and morality. Now, the enemy's strategy is clear. He wants to use rulers like Harris to lead America deeper into spiritual bondage by normalizing sin and rebellion against God. This isn't about left versus right. It's about light versus darkness. It's about aligning with God's kingdom or falling under the control of spiritual forces that seek to enslave humanity. The truth is, God has chosen Trump to carry out his plans and purposes for America. This isn't just about making policies, my friends. It's about restoring God's ways to a nation that's fallen far from God. Trump is far from perfect, but God doesn't call the perfect. He calls the willing. Trump has been willing to stand against the tide of corruption, evil agendas, and godless customs being forced on us. Now, can you see what's happening? Leaders like Kamala Harris are not in power by accident. They are instruments in the hands of principalities of darkness. They are puppets that enforce laws that contradict God's word. The enemy wants rulers who keep people enslaved spiritually and morally. So what's the solution? Prayer. We need to pray that God opens the eyes of our friends who are blinded by deception. The enemy knows that if people start seeing the truth, his grip will be broken. Imagine what would happen if more people realized that the real battle isn't between Republicans and Democrats, it's between light and darkness. We cannot fight this battle with debates and arguments. The real war is spiritual. It's not about convincing people with logic, but praying that God will open their eyes to the truth. We need to pray for those who are under the influence of the enemy, people who support leaders like Kamala Harris without understanding the spiritual consequences. Many of these people, my friends, don't even realize that they are under deception. They are blinded by the God of this world. Their minds have been veiled, preventing them from seeing the light of the gospel. And without that light, they cannot see the true nature of what is happening in America. But the good news is, we have the power to pray. We can ask God to lift the veil from the eyes, to break the demonic frequencies, like Daniel prayed. He repented on behalf of the nation and asked God to break the nation off the bondage that they were under. God can do what no argument or debate can do. He can open their eyes and bring them to the light. Trump's role is part of that divine plan, my friends. And it's time we align ourselves with what God is doing instead of what the media or society tells us. Remember, God has a plan. Nothing the enemy does can stop it. Trump's role is part of that divine plan. This is the time to rise up, not with anger, but with faith. Pray that the people will see the light of Christ and understand the spiritual battle at hand. And pray for courage to stand for righteousness, no matter the cost. Thank you for watching. If this message resonates with you, don't keep it to yourself. Share this video with your friends, your church, and your family. Let's pray together for America and for this upcoming election so that God's purposes will be fulfilled. Comment open eyes below if you're ready to stand in prayer and faith for the truth to be revealed. Together, we will see God's victory. Get ready for it. In Jesus' name.